Hi, everyone. My name is Julian Spirsky. I'm CEO of Uvas. We're a securities exchange. Basically, we've spent a couple of years analyzing just about every exchange on the market. So NASDAQ, Euronext, some DLT exchanges. And we came to a conclusion that exchanges are quite expensive in operations. And consequently, it's very expensive to list and maintain the listing on exchanges because they pass on this pricing. So we endeavored to make an exchange which does two things. A, which is fully backwards compatible with existing exchanges, which means that you can take our tech stack and run it on any exchange you want. So SGX or NASDAQ or whatever. And nobody would notice the difference. You could work with existing broker dealers, with custody, et cetera. And then two, we tried to restructure the what's under the hood to substantially optimize operating costs. And we've managed to do this by reducing operating cost in this exchange by 90 to 95%. Here you see some screens, some just screen grabs from various different interfaces that we have. But it's important to understand that we're an exchange. These are just interfaces to the exchange, which we have many of. But I'll explain a bit later. So funny slide, but we've spent a lot of time negotiating with existing exchanges to become section in various different jurisdictions on their exchange. And then also we're in the process of applying in several jurisdictions, including Singapore actually, for licenses to fully operate an exchange and list trade custody securities. Why is any of this needed? Well, I mean, investors' main reason for investing is diversification. If you look at main exchanges, just in about any country, it's usually the big oil companies or the big banks, or I mean, typically the market cap of, for instance, I mean, if you took Singapore, the first, I think 7 or 10 companies comprise maybe 70, roughly percent of the market cap of the index. So really you're talking about very large companies. We want to some extent, democratize this. And because it's very, very cheap for us to operate the exchange, we pass on the cost savings to the issuers, enabling new innovative companies to list and maintain a listing on our exchange. If you look at this, I mean, looks quite complicated actually. So this is what a regular exchange looks like. You know, each one of these boxes typically is like a physical building. There are many people there doing things. Sometimes the work is not so, streamlined. Not everything is electronic. There are human beings involved. And there are many, many parts, right? So there's like a lot of things going on pre-trade, post-trade is very complicated. Asset servicing has many different components. Essentially, this is very, very legacy and hasn't been changed for the past 30 years. We've redone some of this and tried to basically optimize workflows, but still make it backwards compatible with existing exchanges. And so the main point of the slide is to say, well, look, there's a $2.5 million annual cost, roughly $2.5 million for a company to be listed on exchange. It's just simply too much for any mid-sized company, and which is why exchanges are losing listings. We can reverse this. So, I mean, what I was talking about, this trend actually is very visible here. If you look at the green line, lower left, so number of companies with 500 plus people over the past 30 years goes up precipitously. If you look at the blue line is kind of interesting. So the number of companies, public companies listed on exchanges globally just goes down. It's completely opposite. And so the reason for this is actually it's very expensive to list. It's very expensive to maintain a listing. And we basically want to reverse this trend. I have many slides, so I'll skip a few I'll give you some use cases. So one is, let's say, real estate. It's a much bigger market than capital markets. It's 280 trillion versus 190 trillion. And it's completely liquid, completely doesn't trade. So this is a market ripe for disruption to list on our exchange. Another market is private companies. So for instance, even in developed markets like the US, only 2% of companies are listed. And there are many, many, unicorns that, where the founders have private stock, they're interested in transacting that stock. We can make those assets liquid. And it's, completely ripe for sort of disruption. This is kind of what the landscape looks like. you know, we're in the upper right quadrant. The main point there is companies will be kind of public, so there's liquidity. And then on the x-axis, there's low listing and maintenance costs. If you look at traditional exchanges like London Stock Exchange, Toronto Stock Exchange, SGX, HKX, yeah, there's liquidity, but they're very expensive. And there are substantial costs to operating and being listed on those exchanges. If you look at everything else, it becomes mainly private equity, which there's plenty of, but the secondary market is what it's sort of all about. That sort of democratizes finance, allows people to raise money easily, allows people to make interesting investments.